Now this will be the thing, but they are retaining which thing? This one only, return this instance only. So that's why even if you do typecast here, you will be getting class cast exceptions. You have to make it very clear, okay? Don't think in your way. In some cases it will be according to your scenario. See, I can think in different ways. So you have to understand in which way they have implemented internally, okay? Don't think, okay, this will be the implementation like that. Don't think. Of course, you might be thinking about one, they will be talking about two. If you think about three means they will be talking about two. Like that, the implementations will get differ, okay? Try to understand the implementations clearly, how they have done. We are using these services, right? So we have to understand first their implementations, okay? Please. Now, so this is what? But of course, whenever you do call something on this thread means internally it is going to affect what? This contained object only. I will prove that one to you. Now, see this scenario I am going to prove. This one and this one. Please put this in your brain. Many of the guys are getting confusion here. And I have used this one in our thread priority and also set names directly without making this one as the highlight. In order to set the names like that, okay? Now, it is good opportunity for you to understand this one, okay? Now, what I'm going to do here is, this child thread has to call join method on main thread, right? So, how to get the main thread reference? As I said here, the thread which is going to execute this method, okay? The thread which is going to get execute this method, that thread in instance it is going to create and it is going to put as the contained object in the underlying object. What is that? Thread object type, okay? And even if you do typecasting, you'll get typecasting related runtime exceptions, class cast exception. Okay, please understand me, okay? Now, see here, I want this thread reference. And one more thing, whatever you do call on this one, okay? You do call on this instance, okay? That will impact which thing? Contained object only. Try to understand. I am going to prove that one, okay? Now, let me put one good statement here. What is that? Let me take one static variable. Static variables are accessible in each and every instance and the static area. No issues. Directly they can be used at instance areas. We are going to discuss this one in detail. Please understand me, okay? Now, what is that? Let me declare one variable. Static thread. Why only thread? Why not other things? Let me tell you, okay? See here, if I do take here, current thread, it is a static method. Directly I can use this one because it is inheriting from the parent. No issues, okay? Now, current thread, okay? So now let me know one thing, who is executing this thread? Main thread is executing this method, current thread method. So it is going to create main thread instance and that is going to be acting as the contained instance in our container instance. What is that thread? It is going to create in turn a thread instance. In that it is going to put our main thread instance. So its return type is what? Thread, okay? Put that one like this, okay? Now what is happened for this one? For this one, we have given T reference, okay? Now, why only thread means here? Because I'm going to initialize this particular static variable within the main method, okay? To use this variable or this identifier in the child, where the child thread is going to get executed. What is our scenario here? Child thread has to call join method on the main thread, right? That is what our scenario. Child thread has to wait until completing execution of main thread, okay? Now, first this statement only will get executed, right? Whenever you load program, our piece of dot class file, yes. First this one will come, this one, it is going to start and it will take some time. Thread is not going to be till the end of the start method, okay? It will come half of the middle or in the middle of the start method. After that, I have created the current executing thread instance that I have put as where? In contained object. What is that? Thread. And if you do call, whatever you do call on this instance, okay? whatever you do call on this instance, that will impact this main thread. That is very important. Okay, now see here, now the control will come here. What I am going to do here, I want to call join method on whom? I want to call this child thread, has to call join method on whom? On whom? Parent thread. Where is the parent thread instance? Where is the parent thread reference or identifier? It is here, right? Now we can do access directly within the instance area, right? I have said earlier, which is within the part of our PWFC code only, right? Now see here, just put t dot join, that's it, finished. Than that nothing, guys. Okay, that's it, finished. But thing here you have to understand is current thread method in proper way. See here, I'm calling on t dot join, which thing it is going to impact? It will impact this main thread, that is m thread reference. Okay, that is important. Now the output will be as for this one, what? First main thread only will get execute. Earlier to this one I have showed to you, right? It is giving unpredictable output, so child thread has to wait until parent thread execution completes. Okay, now what will be the answer? Parent 1, like that till 5. After that I'm child, getting 1 to 5, getting this will be our output. Okay, try to observe, I have developed this piece of code earlier itself. Okay, but here which thing you have to make highlight or notice is this part and this part. I'm sure that guys, you will not found this information anywhere. Okay, please try to make notice of these things. Okay, these things comes only through great experience. Okay, no need to worry, do practice, you will get habituate to this one. Okay, please understand me. Now let us go and execute this piece of code. Okay, so same piece of code, nothing change here. You have to take one static identifier of type what? Thread. And you have to make that thread, that is current execution thread instance, to the identifier t, so that we are going to access that one inside the run method, right? Now t dot join, everything is here. Okay, now what should be the output? Whatever I have written about, same thing guys, please observe this piece of code from top to bottom, nothing great here. You have to understand the concept and you have to understand that memory representations whenever you see this current thread. Please understand me. Okay, now let me go and execute this one and let me run this piece of code. Okay, what is this? I am parent 1, I am parent 2. Till the parent thread completes its execution, the child thread will wait. After that only it is going to get execute. Okay, now see, as I said that it is going to give what? See here, underlying object type is what here? I have done this one before, I am explaining to you. Okay, see here, I have created, what is the underlying object? What is the get class duty? It is going to give the underlying object corresponding class, getting? So that's why we have seen what? java.lang.thread. But this thread is containing which instance? Our main thread instance. So even after that, if I do, see here, on thread, see, it is underlying object is thread, right? On thread if I do call join, means what is the meaning? It is useless. So it is containing what? Our main thread instance. Okay, as the contained object. Okay, that's why even if you call t dot join here, okay, within the run method, it is affecting what? Our parent thread, which is what? Main thread. Understand me guys, please. Okay, this and all something pure internals. Okay, you have to go through our API documentation in great way, then only you can get understand this one. Okay, now let us go for, please let us go for other scenario. Please try to observe other scenario, which is very important to us. Okay, now there is one very big concept here guys in our Java. What is that? In our, as part of multi-threading, we are having a very good concept. What is that concept? What is that concept? Deadlock situation. How the deadlock situation is going to arise? Deadlock, that's it. Dead means lock. Deadlock means dead, that's it. It died because of lock. It is not going to come into the live state. Okay, deadlock means our application is going to get stuck. It is not going to re-execute once again, honestly speaking. Okay, now please understand me here one point. Okay, what is that? Here the third scenario is child calling, or child waiting. Okay, child threat waiting until execution of parent threat. Okay, and this poor parent is waiting until execution of child threat. Okay, poor parent is always goes in favor of her or his children, right? If he is a mother or if he is a, I mean, if she is a mother or if he is a parent, I mean, if he is a father, okay, let it be. So in this situation, we are going to get what, guys? Deadlock situation. About this deadlock, we are going to speak, okay? Deadlock means where? It is a condition where waiting times of two threads will be infinite. It is not going to be as a finite one. It is not going to get in. Please understand me, okay? Now, try to understand this one in detail, okay? How to call? Child thread has to call join method and child thread has to call join method and the parent thread reference. Parent thread has to call join method on the child reference. Whatever the two scenarios I have seen here, those I want to combine. That's it. Nothing great here, okay? Now, see here, once again do call this one. What is that? T is equals to current thread, okay? Now, on p dot start, call this join method. Sorry, on p reference, that is child thread reference, okay? And this one, okay? Now, what is this? Parent thread, main thread is calling this method means what? Main thread is going to wait until completion of execution of child thread. And what is this poor child thread is doing here? Here, child thread execution will come, right? Honestly. Yes, child thread will come here. So it is calling join method on parent thread reference, T. It is going to give on thread, I mean which thread is going to execute this method, that thread instance will be available as a contained instance in the underlying object thread. Please understand me, okay? Now, if you do call any method on this T reference, it is going to impact the contained object, right? Now, whatever I have discussed earlier, same thing. Now it is going to be as a deadlock situation. So simple. We are not going to see the termination for this particular program. I mean, no normal termination will be there. Now, I have developed this one and that one only changes. Let me execute that one. Please understand me, okay? Now the same thing. What we have to do? Here, put what? P dot join, okay? Another one is what? That is main thread is waiting until child thread execution completes. Now what is this? Here you call T dot join, okay? What is that? Child thread waiting until the execution completion of main thread, until main thread completes its execution. Understand, please. Okay, now our application is going to be in deadlock situation. Let me compile and run this piece of code. You can just check it here. It is not going to have any normal termination. Of course, see here. It is like that only. What is that? It is in deadlock situation. Here, main thread is waiting for child thread to get complete. And the child thread is waiting to parent thread to complete. But both of them are waiting in turn. You just complete, I'll just complete like that. Both are in infinite waiting time. So what is going to happening here? It is happening in a deadlock situation. There is infinite time. There is no defined time. There is no defined time like 10 seconds or 20 seconds or 1 hour or 2 hours. There is no defined time in between them for waiting. They are waiting for infinite time. That is called as deadlock situation. Okay, what is going to be happen if this scenario is getting happening means deadlock will get happen. Okay, now let us discuss one more scenario which is very important to us. Okay, that is also okay. Now, honestly speaking, if you do follow my first example, all these things will be very easy. The only one trick. Okay, what is that? If a thread has to wait until execution of other thread means it has to call join method on that thread reference in the piece of code where it is going to execute. Okay, if main thread has to wait until completing the execution of child thread means it has to call join method on the child thread reference in its area. That is the trick. Than that, nothing. Okay, now let us go for if a thread A thread calls join method on its reference. What is the meaning of this one? I am waiting until I complete. What is the meaning? Of course, this scenario will not get happen in our real world. But what it is? Technical thing. Technical thing means we are going to convince our information to the JVM through programmatic way. So JVM is also what? It is also step by step program. It is also what? An instructions only. Okay. Group of instructions only. Okay. It is going to arise once again. Deadlock situation. Okay. Try to understand. These two scenarios are very important. You might be not digesting this one as of now, but try to practice it. At least put the code once or twice in your lapis so that you can feel very comfort. Okay. Please understand me. Okay. Now, if a thread calls join method on its own reference, what is going to get happen? Once again, deadlock situation is going to get arise. Getting? Let us go and see this one. Direct line going to execute here instead of this piece of code. Directly, I'll put this is, this one, T dot current thread, okay? Or else, thread dot join. Please don't get confused. I have explained this one. What is that? It is going to return the thread object by containing what? The current thread which executes this method, right? What is this? So now, as I said here, whatever the methods you do call on that one, it is going to impact the contained object. What is the contained object here? Main thread. Main thread instance it is going to contain, okay? Why directly? Current thread, it is a static method which is available in the parent class. Why I have written the code in this way means if you go for any higher technologies of Java, it will be in this way only. Try to practice this one, okay? If you do follow multi-threading from starting session onwards, you will feel very comfort in all these things, okay? If you are not feeling comfort in OOP concepts, I will make it very clear to you, okay? Now, let me go and compile this one. Once again, it is going to give the deadlock situation. Please try to understand this one. Now, see, in earlier code, we have made it as deadlock situation, right? Where waiting time is infinite, right? Still, it is waiting. I didn't do anything. Okay? It is deadlock situation. Even if you come and see this one after 2 years, it will be like this only. Okay? Now, let me terminate this one. Now, what is that? Let me comment this piece of code here. Okay? And let me comment this piece of code also here. P dot join. Now, let me call this current thread dot join, where here, okay, both the threads will be in deadlock situation. Sorry, what is this one? The current thread, thread is calling a join method on its reference, meaning that it is waiting to complete itself. It is meaningless to tell you or to tell this phrase to you, but technically it is true. It is going to give deadlock situation to us. Okay, now try to observe the code. Okay, let me compile once again. Let me run this one. You can just check it here still. Okay, what is this? I'm child. Okay? Okay, let it be. It is going to get executed. Let it be. Now, see here. What is happening here, guys? Okay? It is waiting until the main thread is going to get executed. Okay? So here, what I have done here? See here, why this output we are getting means, we are seeing over console means, see here, where I have called current.join method after the child thread has been started. That's why we are seeing the output this one. And after that, the control will come to this one. It will wait. Okay. For this one, output is what? Whatever we have seen over board. Same thing. What is that? I'm child for 1 time to 5 times. Okay. That's very, very important. Okay. And after executing this one, this is still in joining. That is, it is still in wait state only. I'm waiting for my duty to get executed. When you are going to execute your duty, when your duty is going to get complete, I don't know. And also it is, which is something like meaningless, but technically try to understand this one, you will get it, okay? Don't be as a novice person, okay? Try to understand now this one, okay? Now, this is what the 4 scenarios which I have to be discussed over here. And let me discuss the life of a thread with respect to the join method, okay? It is so simple. Try to focus on this one, okay? Let me take up all these things, okay? What is the life of a thread with respect to what? Join method. Okay, when the join method? How to use the join method? You have to know. If a thread wants to wait until completing the execution of other thread, then it has to call join method on that thread in its area. Please understand this one.